Now, there is no one best computer for anything. There is what you need it for and what you can afford. But if you're using After Effects for animating, designing, editing, in this video, I'm going to break down the four components that you should invest in and also what's exactly in my machine. Now, first, you don't need a top of the line machine to make amazing work. Amazing work from 10 years ago was done on at least 10 year old hardware. Amazing work from 100 years ago was done on pen and paper. And many believe some ancient cave paintings were designed to animate and flicker in the firelight. A literal sandstone wall was at one point the cutting edge hardware for animation. You can make great work on not so great systems. It might just take a little longer. Now, I needed to upgrade because I was starting to film my videos in this glorious 4K resolution, and I was also doing a lot more dynamic linking between Premiere and After Effects, and often having another version of After Effects open at the same time so I could directly screen record that and place that into the edit, and my old computer just couldn't handle it. Now, even if I wasn't admittedly taking the piss by trying to do all of that at once, my computer would just slow down to the point that I was spending more time of my day swearing than actually working. And I had built that PC myself. I had picked out all the parts and put it together. And that was very rewarding, but it was also weeks and weeks and weeks of research figuring out which components I needed, which ones were compatible, and not knowing whether if I put them all together and switch it on, it didn't work, what was I gonna do? So I didn't want that experience again. This time, I called the professionals.
So my name is John Tanyos. I'm the creative director of Smoosh Creative and the technical director of Smoosh Workstations.
John started his own animation and VFX studio and now a company that builds custom workstations for professionals, building machines for some of the best in Australia and New Zealand.
We've rolled out a bunch of systems for Buck Studio in Sydney, but Jess Herrera, Paul Malinsky, Nick Hamilton in Melbourne, Jenny Jiang, who's also an Octane artist.
And now they've built one for me. So no one else was better qualified to help me explain. I asked John for a typical motion designer who's using After Effects, animating, designing, editing, using the Adobe Suite constantly, which components are going to be the most useful things to invest in their machines.
To the animators, I would always recommend a decent CPU with around 8 cores. Any modern 8-core CPU these days come with really high clock speeds. So when we're talking about working in the After Effects timeline or working in Illustrator or Photoshop, generally uses one core, but you want that one core to be quite fast. Generally speaking, the more cores a system has, the slower each core is. Where you'll be burning your money for 2D design and animation is probably getting a 32 core or 64 core Threadripper system. You got all these cores that aren't really going to be doing anything in After Effects, to be honest. For a 2D animator, I would always recommend the absolute minimum 16 gigabyte of RAM, but for a professional, it would have to be somewhere between 32 and maybe 64, depending on how complex your scenes are. Someone's doing just basic 2D animation, I feel like 32 gigabytes of RAM will be enough for a professional or a mid-level. Someone is doing heavy compositing or heavy After Effects motion graphics will probably want 64. And these are for professionals who use these systems day to day. And then SSDs. So you would want a fast SSD drive. And, you know, they're quite affordable now. SSD drives are becoming bigger, larger, and cheaper, and they're extremely fast. So it's important to have a proper SSD drive, which you're running your Windows operating system off, and you're running your projects off as well. You want a fast drive so things can load up quite fast. What you want to do is create a second, have a completely second drive, which is going to be for your project files and system cache for After Effects, After Effects cache. You want to separate operating system and project files, always.
Now, this is because if your C drive is doing all its backend stuff to run the operating system, whilst also you're using it to read and write high resolution video footage and textures and anything really into your projects, you could run into a bottleneck where a hard drive might just not be fast enough to read and write all of those things at once. And also, if your C drive gets corrupted or fails for some reason, you don't want to lose all of your project files at the same time. This way, you can take out the C drive, buy a new one, reinstall the operating system, and you're good to go without having to try to resurrect or recover your files.
for a 2D designer, you probably don't want anything more than an RTX 3060 or a 3070, which is considered a mid-range card. After Effects and Photoshop and all that kind of stuff doesn't really utilize anything beyond an RTX 3070 as much. There are instances where having a better graphics card will make things a little bit faster and snappier, but once again, it depends on what plugins you're using, how complex your scenes are and setups are. But for a designer and animator, just any mid-range graphics card will do fine. I guess if your budget is running a little bit low, you could get something like a 3050 or a GTX 1660, which has a little bit less VRAM and a little bit less raw performance, but it's good enough for design and all that kind of stuff. When it comes to a 3D artist who is starting to use things like Redshift or Octane, that's where you'd want to invest a lot of money or as much as you can in a GPU, because when it comes to render times or just rendering feedback as you're changing your lighting and materials, the faster your card, the better your card, the faster the responsiveness and the render times are going to be. And with 3D designers, and using Octane and Redshift, the more cards you have, you can potentially speed up your rendering as well. So you can start off with one card and render, you know, a scene in 1 minute, and then in Octane, if you were to put it the second of the exact same card in, you could potentially like slash your renders in half just by having second of the same card. And this is where GPU rendering is really, really good and flexible and extremely powerful compared to, you know, rendering using CPU only in Cinema 4D, you know, the physical renderer or standard renderer, which is extremely slow. And that brings it down to like the nuts and bolts. You know, a designer would want a balance between cores and core speed, a decent amount of RAM, and fast memory. GPU generally helps crunch some of those bigger files or formats, or just working faster in the timeline. But that would be my recommendation for a 2D animator.
Now, when I first spoke to John, we first talked about the work that I do and what I needed my machine for, and then they sent me a quote with the parts they think would work best and would suit me. And once we agreed on that, they built it and they sent me this machine, which was secured like it had the crown jewels inside. And Smoosh did a fantastic job with this build. I plugged it in, it worked, I've had no issues. That's great for me. I tried to film some cool shots of it before I mounted it under my desk, but you know what? It's a black box. You know what it looks like. Here is the good stuff. Here is everything inside, so you can see everything that I'm working with. And full disclosure, they did give me a bit of a discount, so I maybe pushed the envelope a little bit on what I would normally get in a machine, mainly with the hard drives, because who can deny the satisfaction of emptying a dedicated cache drive inside After Effects? Ah. I also did notice that my CPU is the AMD Ryzen 9 5950X 16 core, which according to their website is one processor that can game as well as it creates. Well, the same could be said about me. So I have had it for a few months now and it has been great. Seeing all of the big numbers and the fancy names for all the components does make me feel good and make me think that this is a lot more powerful than the machine that I had last time. But it's really once you get stuck in and actually working that you feel the difference. And this thing cuts through renders like butter. Now my YouTube videos typically used to take 15 to 20 minutes to render each one. Now they're taking less than 2. And I can now stack an unnecessary amount of layers and effects in After Effects projects. And is there any better joy than that? Now, I really have to thank John and everybody over at Smoosh Workstations, first of all, for building me this machine with such care and such precision, but also helping me with this video. So please check out their website, follow them on socials, and if you're interested in a new machine, hit them up. And if you want to find out a bit more about my workstation here, what I'm using to mount the PC underneath, what monitors, what everything else I'm using at this desk besides the computer, I've got a full video breaking that down. I'll see you over there. Hello, John. G'day, John. Let's do a couple more of those.
It sounded so awkward.